the national organizing team led by Comrade Nomvula Mukonyane. They were organizing this event and they decided that both provinces must work together to ensure that this is a success. From the proceedings of the day today, it was clear that we have worked so hard. So this is the last part of our leg now that we are starting. So good evening, comrades. Let me acknowledge the Tambo family and thank you for them for allowing us to have this lecture tonight. Thank you to our provincial chaplain, Reverend Andy Lembet, and greetings to the national leadership led by Comrade Gwede Mantashe, Umkwati Kwakunye Kunyeno, Comrade Jesse Duarte, our DSG, our veteran Umamuke Truth Shop is part of us, all the NEC members that are here, but I will mention the one that has been part of us when we're organizing this event, Comrade Nomvula Mukonyane. He has been pushing us every day, even having meetings ebusuku ngabo 7 to 9 and 10. As long as yena engafuna ukulala, bengakwazi usinikeza ichance yokuthi masibe siyalala nathi until this event happens today. We had leadership build up events that were happening in both provinces, and we're focusing in specific areas where we have by elections, but in other areas where, as the ANC, we have not been touching in terms of service delivery issues, especially at the government level. So this is the outcome of the work that we have been doing in honoring Ubabu Oliver Tambo. And we are not going to stop. We have agreed that we will continue with these activities as we have already started as the African National Congress in both provinces with the Women's League. And I want to greet the national leadership of the Women's League in the provinces again, and in the regions and the branches of the African National Congress Women's League. The alliance structures, to all the leaders that are here of the alliance structures from the national, the province, the regions, the zones, and the branches of the alliance partners. Our veterans, all of them that are here, I'm sure you have seen that our participants are growing. We are already now running to 120 participants, but this is a national event indeed. It shows that Lomuntu Esikhulumanga namhlanje is one of the best leaders in the country. Today we are celebrating a life well lived of Comrade Oliver Reginald Tambo, our beloved leader, our father, a husband, a granddad, a community leader, and I dare say a revolutionary of our times, in whom a lot was learned from his exemplary life and the teachings. And I think after this lecture, we'll definitely some of us learn from the things one or two that he has done, because I think we're at a stage now that we must start emulating him. In the parlance of the struggle, would refer to such galaxies in the mold and cloth with a fascinating history. In the examples of the life of Otata Oliver Tambo and many others, which has bequeathed us with the epitome and embodiment of the struggle, the sacrifice and service, we can all learn from these luminaries of our struggle. Now I am, I will call Ulubabalo, but I'm not sure, program director, if you want to say something now, or you'll do it on the second part before we call Ukomrade Lubabalo Mabuyane Usoweto to come and talk to us. Comrade Ngaitobi, do you want to say something, or should I go straight to Lubabalo?
No, go straight to the next speaker, Comrade.
Thank you, Comrade Ngaitobi. Allow me, comrades, now to call Ulubabalo Mabuyane, who will take us through the journey and reflect on the early life and times of Comrade O.R. Tambo. As we all know, Comrade O.R. Tambo originates from the province called Eastern Cape, Pa Ebizana Ezansi Emampondweni. Over to you, Comrade Chairperson of the province, and if you can just lead us with your tribute. Thank you.
Thank you very much, program directors, the Deputy Secretary of Gauteng Province and the Provincial Secretary of Eastern Cape. Special greetings to the national officials and the Central Committee members from our allies.
My apologies. Sorry, my apologies. I think since a mistake, Ilanda baka kaka national chess kwamande bizupisho. Can you allow me to call Bishop first and the interfaith prayer u chaplain wethu ubaba u Bishop Andile Mbete, and then you can continue.
Ngamthandazo
that. Yakwazi ekhaya kaloku
se. I can pray as well.
Yakwazi ekhaya iBhayibheli ivulwa nguwe but masinikeze yena namhlanje uthandaza amasekhaya. Babu Mbete ka usthandazele.
Molweni bethuna. Lemini namhlanje. Andixolise uba ubone ubuso bam kodwa ilizwi uyakulifa. Namhlanje xa siza kuthandaza sivula le lecture katatu OR. I'm reading from Proverbs 18, imizekeliso. Lishumene sibhozo iverse ngu-16. Proverbs 18. Verse 16, a person's vision ushers him or her into the presence of great people. Kasisiza kutata uTambo, we are in the presence of greatness. And greatness, according to this passage, does not come through education. It does not come through your background where you were born, but it is, as the old translation says, a man's vision that ushers him into the presence of greatness. So as we begin to celebrate and salute our great leader, O.R., I would want to remind you in the name of God that we are now coming into a territory called greatness. Because O.R. was a visionary leader. A vision, we are told, is the hidden power that is believed to control future events. Among all our leaders and legends, in my evaluation, a leader like O.R. left us a legacy. Yokuthi, you need to have a vision in life. It is vision that took him from Nkantolo, from Bizana, to international level. And so as we approach this lecture, let us approach it with seriousness and with divine power, knowing that touching him in memory is touching greatness. Let me say three things that a vision does to a person and an organization. A vision gives direction. If you are a person of vision, not a person of sight, but a person of vision, if you know where you want to end before you get there, you will always have direction in your life. A movement, an organization that wants to survive and move forward in spite of difficulties must pray from God to have visionary leaders. Because vision gives direction. Secondly, because vision has power to bridge the present to the future, a vision therefore gives hope. You might experience some difficulties now, But vision becomes a bridge between today and tomorrow. And this is what kept this great leader to lead our movement for many years, not knowing whether they would achieve what they wanted to achieve. But vision gave them a bridge called hope. A hopeless leader, a leader without vision, is a leader without hope. And a leader without hope lives for the present. He's a dangerous leader because he or she cannot see that we don't live for today. We live for the goals that we may not see at the present moment. Thirdly, we salute UOR because he was a visionary leader. Because vision does not just give direction, does not just give hope, but it also creates discipline, self-discipline. You cannot be disciplined from outside in the first instance. You need self-discipline, and only a person with a vision can have discipline. And so before I utter words of prayer for this great man, I want to repeat Proverbs 18, verse 16. A person's vision out of him or her into the presence of greatness. OR was great because he did not, not because he had money in the bank. He was great not because he was driving big cars like some of us. His greatness was based on the vision that he had, and to God be the glory for protecting him until he led us towards our main goal, which was political freedom. Let me conclude by saying, if as your spiritual director, you may ask me, what can I ask on this day from OR, I would refer you to the Old Testament and say there was a leader called Elijah, and there was a young man called Elisha. And before he died, the old man, Elijah, said, "Celinto dikwenzele, dingekasuswa kuwe." Ask, I give you an opportunity to ask for anything before I'm removed from you. And in the words of scripture, this young leader said, "Give me a portion of your spirit." I pray that a portion of Comrade OR, our great father, a portion of his vision, a portion of his spirit, may, because we're talking about him today, may land on some of us. Let us pray. Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you that we have a gift of leaders, especially from the Eastern Cape. Thank you that this nation, this world, experienced the greatness of this man from Bizana. Lord, I pray that you anoint every speaker tonight, that every word they say, every thought that crosses their mind, may lead us to greatness again. Lord, bless the African National Congress. Bless the Republic of South Africa. Bless Africa, give the her leaders a spirit that has got hope, direction, and discipline. Sikelela ke izwe lakowethu, ubone elilizwe, sixolele izono zethu. In the name of Christ, and in his name we pray. Amen. Yabulela kakhulu sihlalo.
Amen. Amen mfundisi wami. Babumbete siyabonga kakhulu ngalo mazwi osipha wona. Indeed, let's not be leaders without hope, because we'll be leaders that are dangerous to our society. And I think we agree with you when you say we really need that portion of Baba O.R. to us so that we are able to lead and be exemplary like her. But the issue of self-discipline that we've spoken about, we really need to ensure that self-discipline, we practice it and it's within us. Mandini tateke ngoketa dandini seku pejula, asikube upejula, achona yoba utmasenze ganjana, gecheni yalo tata, apasuka kona. Apo ebeta koni ndonga. Enkosi ya mwanga pejula. Bambe sana.
Enkosi ya kolo, mpati nkubo, mbulis ni kawazile, kune program directors, mbulis national leadership ya ANC, and leadership alliance yonke our leads and the veterans in particular the family Katamo, comrades and friends and fellow South Africans. Chair, earlier on we spoke that we can't be contesting the lecturer today who will be delivering the lecture, but we should be saying some few words to usher him in as well. I'm really privileged and honored to be part of this important program to do some welcome remarks on the occasion to reflect on the legendary life of President O.R. Tambo, a universally acknowledged giant of freedom and one of South Africa's most admired leaders of the 20th century. Program directors, today is an awesome historic day in our country because on this day, 103 years ago, the community of Ndizana blessed us with one of the finest revolutionaries of our time, President O.R. Tambo. In my brief welcoming remarks to you, comrades of the movement, the combatants of the revolution, and the masses of our people, I wish to highlight few matters reflecting on values of President Tambo and on some activities that we have been engaged on in the province in commemorating and celebrating the life and the memory of President Tambo. First and foremost, I wish to reiterate the profound words expressed by President Nelson Mandela on the occasion of the funeral of President Tambo, where he said, and I quote, "Oliver Tambo has not died because the ideals for which he sacrificed his life can never die. I say that Oliver Tambo has not died because the ideals of freedom, human dignity, and respect for every individual cannot perish. I say he has not died because there are many of us who became part of his soul and therefore willingly entered into a conspiracy with him for the victory of his cause," close quote. Program directors, I'm making this brief remark about greatness of this birthday of O.R. Tambo to challenge all of us to aspire for greatness in service of humanity and the people of our country. Through his life, President O.R. Tambo showed his unwavering commitment to serving the people of South Africa with no expectation of any personal benefit. We must emulate his exemplary conduct and live by values of selflessness, dedication, honesty, and integrity every day as we work to take our people out of abject poverty, unemployment, and inequality. Program directors, I'm fully aware my role today is to just make a brief welcoming remarks, but please allow me to briefly reflect on that. It becomes practically unavoidable to speak of O.R. Tambo outside the context of the historical progression of the African National Congress and the overall liberation movement of our country. Comrades, we remember President Tambo because we fully appreciate that in a protracted struggle, the struggle of men against power is the struggle of memory against forgetting, as articulated by the writer Milan Kundera. Kundera goes on to explain that the first step in liquidating a people is to erase its memory, destroy its books, its culture, its history. Then have somebody write new books, manufacture a new culture, invent a new history. Before long, the nation will begin to forget what is it and what it was. The world around it will forget it even faster. Close quote. Indeed, our premise should be that we assume a collective responsibility to the memory of President Tambo and other heroes and heroines of our struggle. On this day of our country, on this side of our country, I'm sorry, as the leadership of the ANC, we are in Rizana, the birth of place of Oor Tambo, where we're celebrating his birthday by handing over developmental project that will improve the quality of life for Alfred Nzom. We have been here since Sunday, and we were joined by a number of national leaders, Comrade Natin Tetua, Comrade Stellan Dabeni, Comrade Chuete, Comrade Tapa, where we were handing over a technical school that we've built, investing about 40 million, a school that Oor Tambo himself instructed us to actually construct for people of Ngandong. Today, we were further continuing with that program where we're renaming the hospital here, former St. Patrick's Hospital, into Oliver and Adelaide Tambo, where our government has invested almost 400 million. This hospital will provide the people of Mizana with specialized health facilities at their doorstep. After many years of traveling more than 2 hours to access such services in areas of Umtata and other neighboring provinces. I'm highlighting this, comrades, to illustrate that we have given real meaning to the celebration of Oor Tambo today that has a positive impact on people's lives. Oor Tambo did not join politics just to make political statement. He did not spend all those decades in exile mobilizing the international community to cut economic ties with apartheid South Africa for fun. He wanted to change the material conditions of our people, the poor and downtrodden. And he understood that achieving political freedom is the first step towards the realization of that goal. So we were with the people of Mbizana to pass a message that the organization of Oor Tambo that is leading in government continues to live and continues to lead, not with slogan, but by implementing practical programs to effect fundamental transformation in their lives. We are also committed to aspire for greatness in our work of serving our people, because Oor Tambo was a great leader. We were honest and frank with people of Ngandolo that we are not proud that during our time of leading government, the majority of our people are still unemployed, live in abject poverty and glaring inequality. We've committed to renew government as a vehicle for social transformation. We've committed to rid the government system of the bad things we have seen in the recent past, such as endemic corruption and poor service delivery that have really brought the name of ANC into disrepute. As the Eastern Cape ANC, we hope this is the attitude that will actually be adopted by all members of the ANC across the country. In the 20 by-elections we have in our province, Bizana has won at Ward 24. I've just addressed the Siyanqoba rally there this afternoon. Our people have spoken unequivocally and said they still have faith in us. They still trust that we can right our wrongs, and they rely on us to fulfill the objectives of the National Democratic Revolution. Thank you very much, program directors, for allowing us a few minutes to do welcoming remarks in this historical joint program of two provinces. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Chairperson. Siyabonga kakhulu ngamazwi osiphe wona. So, Chair, now we're going to move to the next item. We are supposed to have an input from the family, but the Comrade Mandla will indicate when the family has managed to log in, because they've been trying to log in. I think we have a technical problem, but once they are in, Mandla, you will indicate that. Now we're going to move to the international message from one of the organizations that have been working, Nobaba. One of those will be Olive Pame. Can I hand over to the person that will be leading us? Yes, thank you.
Comrades, as you have gathered to commemorate the memory of Oliver Tambo, allow me to send my best wishes on behalf of the Olof Palme International Center. The friendship between Oliver Tambo and Olof Palme, two remarkable leaders, so important to both our countries, to both our movements, live on through our organizations. We value and treasure their memory, the wisdom of their great minds, and the pureness of their hearts continue to inspire us, but also obliges us to lead by their example. The world is suffering from a trust deficit disorder, to borrow the words of UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres. Especially young people do not trust politics, do not trust democracy to put the world straight, to bring a brighter future. Democracy is backsliding, and we see a plague of nationalism and authoritarianism sweeping across the world. Disguised in a populist narrative about building walls, putting our own country first, and turning our back on international cooperation. But the challenges we face, we must face them together. Climate change, social tension at risk of causing more conflicts, migration and the disastrous effects of the corona pandemic on our societies, causing unemployment, poverty and hunger, all this must be fought back with clear progressive policies, building resilience, strategies of mitigation, fighting inequality and infusing hope. Political reforms creating a society for all, leaving no one behind. And not the least, to lead by example. Inspired by the great Oliver Tambo and Olof Palme. The solidarity between our countries live on through the friendship of our two movements, born in the friendship of Oliver Tambo and Olof Palme. And true friends, we shall remain in good times, but also when the ride is filled with bumps. Our solidarity with South Africa and the South African people will. Some of you might know that Olof Palme, when talking about the struggle against apartheid, often ended his speeches by saying, "If the world decides to abolish apartheid, apartheid will disappear." After a long struggle, far too long, and with far too many sacrifices, we managed to reach the goal. Apartheid was abolished. But the challenges, of course, did not end. But let these words remain an inspiration to us in our daily struggles. If the world decides to abolish poverty, poverty will be abolished. If the world decides to fight climate change will be halted. We can do it, but we must do it together, with wisdom and purity at heart. Amandla, comrades, amandla.
Away too. Thank you so much for the reflections on behalf of our international friends, and we will still continue with that relationship. In fact, our head of organizing, Menomvula Mkonyana, she was talking about the role that we should pursue, not only wait for the International Relations Subcommittee, but as an organizing unit of the ANC, in reviving the relationship that we have been having with yourselves and other organizations that have been helping us as the African National Congress. So we really appreciate those words. We will definitely work with you even after this, not only come when we have lectures. Thank you so much for that. And now we'll move to the, I will hand over to Nugai Tobi, but there will be a song that will come, and then Ntakwethu bengayazi nokuthi benze nepotism lapha Petula uba apha lo mfolongo wasekhaya iclan yasekhaya. So hayi ke ANC sihlanganisile mfokaba, kunandaba Jola, ibambe ngokwakho, mna ke ninikeza la kuyintambo. Enkosi.
Oh, Thank you very much, Comrade Nomanto Mangwanya, for leading us to this stage. Comrades, as a matter of courtesy, let me just greet all the leaders that are conversed here today to celebrate the life and times of this giant of our revolution, Ubaba Oliver Tambo, the national leadership of both the ANC and the allies that are gathered here, and the leaders of the leagues and everybody else, and the veterans of our struggle. We have been given this great opportunity to steer the process forward, so I will not make any remarks, therefore, except to say from the ANC Youth League National Task Team, we have been given the name of Comrade Sizophila Mkhize. I hope she is already here. From the ANC Women's League, we have been given the name of the Deputy Secretary General, Comrade Wesizwe Tikana. From the ANC Veterans League, we have been given the name of Comrade Ule Majoa. Then from COSATU is Comrade Mike Shingange, I saw him. And the SACP is Comrade Letesa Tinori. So those are the comrades that we will be calling for to come and speak. I hope they have already joined us. Can I therefore take this opportunity to request that all speakers cannot speak more than 3 to 4 minutes at worst. 3 to 4 minutes, just a few words to mark this particular day from both the leagues and the alliance components. Can I therefore invite Comrade Sizophila Mkhize from the ANC Youth League National Task Team over to you, Com.
Thank you very much, Comrade Program Director. Greetings to you and your co-program director. Greetings to the leadership of the ANC present as led by the National Chair. I understand Alliance partners, the ANC Women's League and the Veterans League, MK Progressive Youth Alliance. Ladies and gentlemen, comrades, we meet here to celebrate Comrade O.R. Tambo, an outstanding leader of the ANC and also a founder of the ANC Youth League. It is quite difficult, comrades, to sit here representing the ANC Youth League in this lecture of Mdala, knowing very well that wherever Mdala is, he's not at all pleased with the state of the ANC Youth League. Comrade Mdala would want to see young lions going to their conference and continuing to champion the interest of young people and rallying young people behind the banner of the ANC. We believe in the leadership of the ANC that it will assist the ANC NYTT to finally deliver not only a Congress, but a credible Congress of young people where they will shape their own future and also elect leaders of their choice. We cannot speak about Mdala and detach him from the ANC Youth League. While we celebrate this giant, I believe it is quite important that we speak to the foreign tendencies we have seen in the ANC, where comrades publicly insult each other, where they fight each other publicly, bringing the name of the ANC into disrepute. In honor of Comrade Tambo, the unity of the movement is sacrosanct. The unity of an organization that Tambo served all his life and sacrificed for it is very important. Now, as an organization, our people are not interested in our internal fights, squabbles, but they are much interested in what the ANC is going to do to change their lives. Young people are swimming in a pool, in a dark pool of unemployment and poverty. The means of production continues to be in the hands of the white minority. Our people are killed and abused in farms. White people are burning state cars and insult us daily. South African women are living in fear because in any day can be the day they get raped or killed. We have too many problems to focus on and give solutions to. We have no reason to be fighting amongst each other while our people are looking up to us and are looking up to the movement of Comrade O.R. Tambo to bring the end to their misery and take them to the promised land. The 9-meter statue of President Tambo that was unveiled today by President Ramaphosa shows Comrade Tambo holding a freedom charter in his hands. These are the basics we all need to get back to.
Comrade, surely you have been muted because of time. I am not certain because I can see that you have been muted. If it's because of time, our dear apology. We have placed before the meeting 4 hours. Thanks very much for your input to this particular occasion.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much. Thanks very much. Comrades, we have put this technology to be automated. After your 4 minutes, you will be automatically muted. Thanks very much to the ANC Youth League National Task Team. Comrade Tikana Weziwe, DSG of the ANC Women's League, over to you. Comrade Tikana Weziwe, it's your turn. The ANC Women's League, DSG. Are you there? Comrade Tikana Weziwe, your 4 minutes has started. Are you available?
I'm trying to unmute, Comrade, as I told you.
Thanks very much. Over to you again. Sims Mamkwati, you still have difficulties.
Can you?
Is she fine? We are going to give you an opportunity. If you have difficulties in connecting, we can give over to Veterans League and come back to ANC Women's League. Although in terms of the planners, that was not going to be ideal. Are you there, Comrade Tikana?
I'm trying, Nopala.
Yeah.
I'm not, yes. Let me switch off the video, then I continue. We are joining the masses to celebrate and remember a life of an outstanding South African, President Oliver Reginald Tambo, who against all odds led the African National Congress for more than 30 years and still managed to bring it back home as a united and strong weapon that must lead our people into the democratic transition. President Oliver Tambo represented both integrity and selflessness and at all material times. His comrades were able to speak to both our innermost desires as the oppressed and exploited. Today, as Women's League and broader South African women, we salute the outstanding contribution President Oliver Tambo made in contributing towards shaping a progressive narrative of the challenges faced by women on the home front and the globe. In 1984, the ANC in exile at that time and still not fashionable to be its member, President O.R. Led the struggle for liberation of women and other people to led us to the victory on the basis of the involvement of the masses, including the women in their millions as a conscious and active part of the anti-racist and anti-colonial democratic movement of South Africa. Taken together with the strides he made in ensuring that women did not just and grow up being a static within the ranks of the liberation movement, but also ensured that their occupied leadership position in all the battlefronts identified and legitimized platforms of engagement to dislodge the enemy. Last week, President Ramaphosa has unveiled the framework with which South Africans must seek to reposition itself economically, arising from the COVID-19 imposed challenges and those occasioned by history. It is through these gain strides and the South African women must be allowed to define themselves. Of quality importance is the unanimous confirmation by our National Assembly of Ms. Takani Maluleka as the new Auditor General of South Africa, at first among women in South Africa. This groundbreaking decision affirms the essence of the commitments made by our movement in the person of President O.R. Tambo. We dare say that today's decision has left our outstanding patriot, internationalist, revolutionary by excellence, with a smile of contentment and satisfaction that his dream of free and a democratic society, free of gender stereotyping, is steadily being realized. In this regard, we must, as young women and women in general, commit ourselves to endless struggles against all forms of abuse and killing of women and children as in its assault on the vision and progressive through Mdala. We will continue as Women's League to ensure that we place a high premium on the program aimed at the upliftment and support of women, as well as to support young people's program. We must, as we celebrate the life of this great patriot and outstanding revolutionary, ensure that we deserve protocols against the spread of coronavirus because it is still with us. Also, we must spare no strength, no effort in our fight against gender-based violence. Amandla.
Thank you very much, Mkwatikazi. Ixesha lakho libambile. Indeed, Women's League leadership, we will never claim to be free as long as women of our country are not free. Can we therefore request that Comrade Pule switches on his mic, his video, and represent the veterans of our struggle? Comrade Pule, are you there? If you are there, please switch and speak to us. Comrade Pule, on behalf of the Veterans League, we are all yours. Ukhona ma comrade uqala. Ungathanda sibize umuntu ongekhoya.
I saw u comrade.
Bani comrade ukhoya?
U SG we Veterans League. I didn't see comrade Pule.
SG of the Veterans League, are you the representative of the Veterans League? If so, speak to us.
Comrade Lulama, good evening. We suggested the name of Comrade Pule Majwa to speak on behalf of the Veterans League. And he has all the speeches that we requested that he should put together. So it will be difficult for me to say, though, of course.
He's on. He is around. He's just muted.
Okay. Thank you so much,
Comrade Chair. Comrade Majwa, Comrade Pule, can you speak? Can somebody assist you to switch on the mic? Thanks, Ashton. Yeah. Carry on. Comrade Pule? We should be patient with the veterans. I just hope that he is trying to switch on his mic. Is Comrade Pule in?
He is in, but muted,
What we can do under the current circumstances, whilst he is being assisted, is to call on COSATU, the Deputy President, Shingange, to mute on and speak to us. We'll try to assist the Veterans League to carry on. Deputy President, over to you.
Thank you very much, Program Director. I wanna try and beat this technology of 3 to 4 minutes. And by that, I want just to greet you and through the National Chairperson, Comrade Gwede, greet all the officials and the leadership of the ANC, our veterans, the Youth League and the Veterans League and the Women's League, including the Communist Party as led by Comrade Lechisa. Indeed, today for us as COSATU is a very important day for our movement, the African National Congress, and that of the people of South Africa, for a giant and a legend was born into the country of South Africa. we are honored to be here, not because we're going to offer a message of support, but because we are part of those who are paying tribute and remembering this giant that ever walked the soil, but also that is inspired the rest of the revolution that was carried over a number of decades in this country. For the sake of time, Chair, without preamble, our message of support to the movement that the Oliver Reginald Tambo led is that we as the workers, the advanced detachment of the working class, considers ourselves as the motive force of the achievement of the ideals of the revolution that Oliver Tambo stood and fought for. We consider ourselves to be the people or the class in society that is going to benefit when the ANC or when the NDR achieves its objective. And we consider ourselves to be the ones that are going to be the receiving end in case the objectives of the NDR are not achieved. In that context, we want to implore on all of us, the movement of Oliver Tambo, to at least rediscover that which Oliver Tambo stood for, fought for, and I must add, he died fighting for, in order for all the aims and objectives of the Freedom Charter, the NDR, to be achieved, because in that, we will have answered the question at this moment in particular that is pronounced more than ever before, the question of the class-divided society, who do we represent as things stand today? That's the second point we wanted to raise, that in a class-divided society like South Africa is, more and more people of South Africa are looking on the liberation movement to pronounce and to identify itself with a class that they represent, notwithstanding the fact that we consider ourselves a multi-class organization. But there's a class that we sought to liberate, there's a class that we sought to emulate, to emancipate, there's a class that we sought to make sure that they participate in the economic activities of this country. The third thing we want to raise, which is the second last point, Chair, over and over again, Oliver Tambo will have pronounced on the importance of the alliance and the importance of the unity of the alliance and the fact that the alliance in this country is one special gift that the South African people have in order to persecute the National Democratic Revolution. It is in this context that we call upon all alliance partners to try and rediscover that which united them, that which connected them, that which made it necessary for them to fight side by side in the trenches for the liberation of this country, and until the attainment of each and every objective of the NDR and the Freedom Charter, that it is necessary for us to hold hands and stop bickering and unite ourselves. Our last message of support we want to raise as we remember and wish Comrade OR a happy birthday and salute the family of OR. We want a more pronouncement by our movement on the plans we have when it comes to the ANC Youth League. It is our view that for quite a number of years, we don't seem to have a clear plan about what we want to do with the youth of the African National Congress. Our view is that when Chairperson Gwede Mantashe and Ngugai Thobi are no longer leaders of the ANC, the preparatory school of the leadership of the ANC that are supposed to galvanize the young people into the ideals and into the fold of the ANC, when they are being incapacitated as they are now, who in what, where is the second layer of the leadership of the ANC going to come from? And I'm not just saying about talking about the second layer of the leadership of the ANC by name and warm bodies, but I mean in terms of the political concepts that will have built, the political development, the education that will have been built, and the participation of the young people in the struggle and also in the life of our movement. We think it is high time that we pronounce clearly on our plan, on the future leadership of our movement, which becomes the future leadership of our country and therefore of the liberation movement. We say to the family, thank you. We say to the movement, thank you. We say to Comrade OR Tambo, long live your spirit, and indeed, happy birthday. Thank you very much, Comrade Chairperson. I hope I've beaten your 2 minutes.
Thanks very much, Comrade Singange. Just remember that I'm still within the
age limit of the youth league. So it's going to be Comrade Gwede Mandashe that you can think about, not myself. I'm still in the ANC league. Thanks very much for the message. Can we therefore call on Comrade Tepule? We have seen his hand up. Comrade Tepule, you are given an opportunity to speak to us from the Veterans League. Thanks very much. Can see you.
Thanks, comrades, program directors. I'm Pule Matwa, and I would like to greet the leadership present in this program. Before I start saying what I would like to say about our leader, Comrade President O.R. Tambo. In our view, this is a very important occasion for the celebration of the life well lived by Comrade O.R. Tambo in the prosecution of our national struggle of liberation. Comrade Tambo was given one of the most difficult tasks in the liberation movement, the task of having to mobilize the international community for our struggle. And I hope we are not going to disappoint him by not continuing along the road that he had started and traveled. He went out of the country following the task he was assigned by his beloved movement. He prosecuted that task with all his determination and delivered the goods. The freedom we are enjoying today is the freedom that he and his colleagues fought for in the many difficult years when the enemy was persecuting our people in all fronts. We feel really honored that we saw today the unveiling of his statue at the airport named after him. And we listened to very many important and interesting speeches by the leadership of our country. We are also very happy that at last the school of O.R. Tambo has been opened, which was one of the things that we delayed in doing. Hence the many problems that we are confronted with today. Lack of political education, which is a result of younger people not being guided along the lines the ANC had prepared in the past. It's succession plan. I cannot think that we will face the same problems now that the school is on and the teaching is going on, which will assist a lot of us to clear our minds and understand what we want to achieve for our people. The revolution is not yet over, and the problems of the revolution are many. One of the most serious problems of the facing the revolution today is our people not being able to speak less to the media whenever it's necessary to say things. They must discuss them within the organization itself, where they will get the correct answers. The media will not give them the correct answers, instead will try to divide us with all the things that we say. If we could speak less and do more, we will shorten our route to final victory. I thank you, comrades, for listening. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much, and that Majwa. Thanks very much for such an inspirational talk to us tonight. We will have missed it could you have not connected and spoken to us. Thanks very much, Dan. Comrades, we should move on to request Comrade Senode from the South African Communist Party, an ally of the African National Congress, a backbone of the working class struggles, to speak to us. Comrade Senode, can you speak to us tonight about O.R. Tambo?
Thank you very much, Comrade Chair. I hope I'm audible. I bring revolutionary greetings and love, revolutionary love from the South African Communist Party to OR's family and his larger family here at home and internationally, as we've just heard from the Olof Palme Institution, on this important date in his life. He left us a legacy of great internationalism and solidarity worldwide. In addition, we cannot forget his passion in the battle for the advancement of women and gender equality. The current levels of gender-based violence and femicide would have outraged him. In addition, he also left us a legacy of bravery, often leading from the front with integrity, ethically, and with respect. The current problems we face require such bravery. The party cannot forget the deep respect and of revolutionary relationships he had, not only with the party, but with its allies, in general. His trusting relationship with luminaries in the revolution of the parties and elsewhere, such as Moses Kotane, J.B. Marx, and Yusuf Dadu, cannot be forgotten, as I said. O.R. was a team player par excellence in his pursuit and work with collectives in the realization of the National Democratic Revolution. Speaking of the alliance, he said, our alliance is a living organism that has grown out of struggle. So the call and work of the reconfiguration of the alliance is a call to build on his example and legacy, although under different challenging conditions. Our call this October to focus on human settlement, health, hunger, and water are intended to prioritize conditions that will benefit the majority of OR's people, the working class. He never lost his way, however difficult the environment was. He kept himself upright, conducted himself ethically and with integrity, built relationship, not only in the alliance, but globally, some of which endure to this day. The best tribute to him is to emulate him in this respect, to re-earn the confidence of the people he fought for and with throughout his revolutionary life. Nothing less will do. OR's best contribution, as someone already said, one of the comrades, that when he returned back home, he was able to deliver the movement intact, and he said so, and that he hoped that the leadership and members would ensure that the ANC and the movement, broadly speaking, including the alliance, is kept intact. We owe his memory and tribute the work that is difficult that must be done to build the alliance into a stronger force. The challenges we face in the climate change, as said, for example, but also in the economic trajectory that is necessary post-COVID, is critical that we work together around this, because otherwise any other departure or detour from this trajectory runs the risk of increasing the levels of poverty, inequality, and unemployment that would truly be unacceptable to him and his comrades that he worked with closely, not only in the country, as I said, but also elsewhere. We owe it to OR to build consistently all the time in the manner that we are proud of his legacy. It is true, and I agree, that today's appointment of the new Auditor General, as Comrade said in the debates today in Parliament, was a tribute to his leadership, his vision, and we should stay true to it in bringing about an unracial, non-sexist, democratic, and hopefully egalitarian society. Thank you very much, Comrade Chair.
Thanks very much, Comrade Senodi. Thanks very much for those wise words from the party, trusted party of our people. Comrades, we should move on. In terms of the program, Comrade Nomandu, we're supposed to be giving over to DSG, but there was an element from your previous talk that the family was supposed to be speaking, giving a message on this day, serious day, important day of the birth of Dada Oliver Tambo. I'm not certain whether the family has been reached so that we can give that opportunity for it to make a message. I'm not sure whether Comrade Nzwandile did indeed got them so that they can speak. We also have a video. I think that video can be played, Comrade Phoebe, just a few minutes. I hope that is from the family. If that is in tandem with that particular family speech, then we can allow it. Comrade Phoebe, there's something that you are posting. Has Comrade Mzwandile found the family through the telephone conference or the video? Yes, Commissioners. Oh, okay.
South Africa will be transferred to a country of all South Africans, of all races and creeds. That is inescapable. What was happening lately?
Join the thing and
repression was so intense that the enemy dictated conditions of silence. People didn't say anything and they avoided doing anything, but they were waiting. Because in the early 60s, cadres left the country for military training. So the people were waiting. Well, the ceiling of repression was broken in the early 70s, in part as a result of the actions by the ANC, for example, the clashes in what was then Rhodesia, in Wanki, where the ANC was involved together with Zimbabwean liberation forces. That opened the gates, and the people began to come out more boldly. This was 1967, 68. So during the early 70s, there was a growing buildup, even within South Africa, because people had become more defiant. The enemy could not contain the determination of the people anymore. And so then you then began to get the mood of resistance and defiance, which the ANC had inculcated during the 50s. Massacre stunned and shocked us and angered us greatly. It was something we could least have expected after the experience of Sharpeville. In Sharpeville, was a tremendous shock to our people. 1976 caught us unprepared. We were still building up on mass mobilization and building up on our armed struggle. But we found ourselves unable to respond to this brutality. After that, the struggle was at a new level, and we had to quickly adjust to that new level. Young people were coming out by the hundred for military training. We didn't have the facilities to handle so many at the time, but we had to organize ourselves and provide training. Yet others were really too young to be military trained. There was another area of training that our people needed, and that was academic. And so we began to conceive of the idea of establishing a school to take in the young people who had been forced out of school. That is how we developed what was later to become the Solomon Mahlangu Freedom College.
on this occasion, the world is with us in support, guaranteeing that we shall win. Amanda! Mata! Mata! All power!
Thanks very much, the team. Congratulations for that particular video. Indeed, we owe our freedom and our liberation greatly to his inspiring leadership. We have to move on, given that the family has not been found up until now, to hand over to the Deputy Secretary General of the African National Congress, Comrade J.C. Duarte, to make her own remarks and introduce us to the guest speaker for the evening. Our DSG, over to you, Comrade.
Comrades, good evening, and Amandla. Today is indeed a very special day as we remember one of the most remarkable leaders of our time, and also, I believe, one of the greatest leaders the ANC has ever had, because of the length of time that he led us and the legacy that he has left behind will live on for many generations to come. And hopefully it will rub off on us the values that Comrade O.R. Tambo left, the values of integrity, humility, honesty, and passion for the people of South Africa and for making sure that we are able to bring about a better life for all. Every era chooses leaders for its own time, and leaders with passion, able to lead us, able to work very hard, and able to give us a sense of security and hope, and leaders that can unite our movement. Tonight is I have a very easy task. It is a great honor for me to introduce somebody to you that you know very well, and whom I have had the honor and privilege of working at Luthuli House with for 10 years, and being a member of the officials together with him for now 8 years. And I can say to you that you know that Comrade Gwede Mantashe was born in Kala. He's one of the Eastern Cape's sons. He's a trade unionist who cut his teeth in the mines of South Africa, the Western Deep Mine. He was a rock driller, a shop steward of the NUM, an organizer of the MUN. Comrade Gwede has 2 master's degrees, one from Wits University and another from Mankosa. He's worked in various parts of our country. He's worked in Prisca, he's worked at the Matla Collieries. He became the branch chair of the NUM in Witbank. He went on to become the NUM's regional chair in 1985. And in 1988, he became the national organizer for the NUM. He was also elected the chair of the South African Communist Party in 2012. He's currently a political Politburo member. And he was elected the Secretary General of the ANC in 2007 and served 2 terms in that position. A famous quote by Comrade Gwede in 2010 at the memorial lecture of Violet Siboney, where he said, "The new order after 1994 inherited an entrenched value systems that placed individual acquisition of wealth at the very center of the value system of our society as a whole." As he was re-elected as our SG, Comrade Gwede's ability to help us understand the moments that the ANC was in over various periods, to analyze it, to provide us with a diagnostic report just before the NASREC conference that gave us a sense of what we needed to do to set our movement straight again. His ability to find ways of uniting people is perhaps his greatest quality. And for me and for most of us who've worked with him, we can only say that it is indeed a pleasure and an honor for us to have him as tonight's keynote speaker, the national chairperson of the African National Congress, and also the current Minister of Mineral and Energy. It is my humble task to introduce Comrade Gwede Mantashe. Comrade Mantashe? Comrade Gwede? Unmute. Comrade Mantashe, please go ahead.
Thank you, Comrade DST. You know, this technology, when you are born before technology, it cuts you off at the wrong moment. Thank you very much. Let me first talk to and thank the program directors for leading the program so well. Leadership of our movement at all levels of our movement, branches, regions, provinces, and national. DSG and Nomvula, when they force you into undertaking a task of the ANC, they don't have in their vocabulary the word please. They just tell you you'll do this and you end up in the Eastern Cape delivering a lecture. Alliance partners of our movement, leagues, veterans of our movement, I've seen a number of them. Veterans. Everybody who took time to be in this lecture today. I think let's start off by declaring our love to the Tambo family. We love Dali, we love Tembi, we love Tsilane, we love the bigger family of Tambo, Apa and everywhere else. We must appreciate that this family is unassuming and respects all of us irrespective of our roles. I think that is a special tribute to this family. We celebrated the year of Oliver Tambo and the year of unity in action in 2017. And we should continue celebrating every year to express our appreciation contribution to the struggle for freedom. Here's from a special generation, the Youth League of 1944. That led our movement for 5 decades, successfully and delivered the ANC, or allow it to collapse in our hands when greed subsumes principles that colleague Comrade Oliver Tambo stood for. The ANC would weaken and ultimately die. That is what we are racing against. Some of us take this for granted and behave casually and not notice or ignore the threat. We must survive this threat and have programs that strengthen the ANC against all odds. We're celebrating the life and times of Oliver Tambo. I call him the most distinguished leader of our movement. A leader was head and shoulders above all. A leader who kept our movement intact during the most difficult phase. Oliver Tambo brought exceptional personal attributes and also learned from the collective experience of struggle. It is these experiences that gave our movement the nature and character. Character is what makes you distinct and different with everybody else. And therefore, the ANC is what it is because of the contribution of Oliver Tambo. Somebody said to me, and I repeat this all the time, that, listen, you don't know you don't know Oliver Tambo. We worked with him, almost implying that Tambo should be eulogized by those who worked with him. And I said to this comrade, that is selfish and narrow owning of Oliver Tambo. And I remind him of something that I always remind people that, listen, Christians, when they talk about Jesus, you can think that they were with him last week. When you talk to Muslim and you hear them talking about Prophet Muhammad, you can think that they were with him in the mosque this afternoon. And when you go to a country like Cuba, a revolutionary, they celebrate Jose Marti as if he departed last month. Our revolution cannot be hamstrung by selfishness of narrow owning it. I would love to hear school kids talking about Oliver School. We must all learn and emulate Lodestar. OR was in the pursuers of National Democratic Revolution. He represented the best to elicit such attributes to our memorializing. We are a revolutionary movement of Oliver Tambo, who is the majority of our people. That's why contesting elections is not just an exercise. It is about testing the popularity of the movement among the people. And all the time we have a responsibility and a duty to ensure that we represent the vast majority of our people. We must represent the most scientific development and be the home of the brightest minds in our society. To be able to fulfill all these, we must ensure that there is trust between the movement and the people. We must represent these scientific developments and be the home for the present society. To be able to hold this, the trust between the people and the movement must be at its highest. Therefore, it is our duty to ensure that Oliver Tambo, representing a link between ourselves and the people, and if we're fighting like cats and dogs amongst ourselves, we are destroying the most important value of trust of the people to our movement. Now, we're at a stage when people are fast losing trust in our movement. It is their movement because of this is harming the brand of the movement of Oliver Tambo. The SC cannot afford being equated to corruption because individual members and leaders cannot suppress their greed. Therefore, that duty and that message must come up strong to each one of us, and we can take exception, but the message must be consistent. We must continuously ask the question, what kind of the SC do we want to build? We must talk and appreciate the importance of unity of our movement. Even those who agree in meetings to the unity and the message and immediately go out to factional caucuses must be engaged. We must, on an ongoing basis, talk to their conscience. Unity is a function of diversity of ideas being a source of strength. Unity is not homogeneity of ideas, but ability to persuade one another. It is about uprightness. So that we don't second guess one another. We must always know where we stand with one another. We must fight against corruption, and we must intensify that fight. The Zondo Commission, we have different views about it. We must support it, support and accept it as a formula for the movement to cleanse itself. Information that is coming out of this commission is a serious illustration of how deep the rot is. And the temptation to want our conduct to be compared to apartheid regime is a formula for a disaster. Society is correct in expecting our conduct to be of high standard because we are revolutionaries. If whatever state in its conduct, Bishop held out sufficiently how much ethical and moral principle mattered to Tambo, far more than any political philosophy. Oliver Tambo belongs to the generation of leaders described by Yusuf Dadoo when talking about Moses Kotane as incorruptible. Incorruptible not only in his politics, but also in his personal life. He was a man you knew could not let you down, never do something behind your back, never deceive you. You always knew where you were with Oliver Tambo. Sometimes his words were harsh and hurtful, but they were never dishonest. As the leader of our movement today, we as leaders of the movement today, can we be upfront and say we are incorruptible? Truth stand and falsehood as short legs. Rejoice if they tell lies about you knowingly, because history will be on your side. Leadership of our movement must be constructive in dealing with criticism. To be criticized is not being insulted, but shown what is in your blind spot. When people criticize you, they say there is a danger that you are not seeing because it is in your blind spot. Oliver Tambo demonstrated this in his handling of allegations directed at the leadership and the movement in the period leading to the first Conservative Conference. He insisted on addressing the issues raised. Morogoro became a watershed conference because members of the organization to change leadership, including himself. What came out of the Conservative Conference continued to guide the movement. Strategies and tactics was formalized. Four pillars of the revolution were concretized. Today, various groups are criticizing and labeling the leaders. Our ability to listen and appreciate the views expressed will make the movement grow stronger. The second Consultative Conference in Kabwe in 1985 was regarded as a crisis. It is Oliver Tambo who turned that crisis into its head. He termed it the crisis of our advances, a crisis of making our advances quicker in all fronts. It was in this conference that the decade of freedom was declared. This proved to be prophetic as we attained our freedom in 1994. Armchair revolutionaries are critical and others see 1994 breakthrough as a sellout. They need time to learn that it was not luck, but an outcome of intensive struggles. The decade of liberation gave us details, in particular in a chapter in Oliver Tambo speaks that talks about our bases are inside South Africa. The regime did not even need to find the ANC, but bombed bases to work on the psyche of their followers. There was no ANC camp in Matola. Massacres in Maseru and Gaborone cannot be explained up to this day. They constitute psychology on their followers. It is Oliver Tambo who ended our movement in 1991. With the hope, today the movement is in a crisis all around. The ANC must revive and renew itself. The alliance must strive to maximum unity. We must resist the temptation to present it as being evil and everyone being a saint. We must confront the challenges facing the movement. We must engage in the space of the battle of ideas. We must defend the ANC ideologically. The ANC deserves our support and defense. The economy, for example, is not performing and the growth is sluggish. when we engage in the debate about reviving our economy, few ideas come to the fore. We spend all our time discussing processes, economy is practical. With economic reconstruction and recovery plan, our focus should be on implementing practical programs. The debate on energy is one of the highlights possible of encirclement, where weak is forced to advance ideas of the powerful. We are told to destroy everything that was strong at and adopt a philosophy that is adopted by developed economies. And the risk is immeasurable. I can share with you that when we went to the G20 conference, everybody agreed that we must use and access every technology and source of energy at our disposal as we reduce carbon emissions to society. Technology of clean coal for continued use because the marketing of renewables based on destruction of other technologies. We must enter this debate with interest and the need in uniting the movement for the sake of amongst ourselves with the aim of reaching agreement. Let me close by making the call that ANC members will do the leaders of Oliver Tambo good if leaders and members can donate clothes for the poor in centers set up in communities where we live, because that contribution may appear small when you make your own deduction. Please make that contribution and continue to show that the ANC is a caring organization. Thank you very much. You cannot finish a lecture on Oliver Tambo, I can say that. We can talk about everything. Coronavirus is in our face. Many think that there will be post-coronavirus. My own view is that we must just adapt ourselves to living with coronavirus in our midst, but strengthen the health prescriptions to be safer. We must be vigilant. We must save many people. Thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity. Thank you very much, Program Director.
Thanks very much, Comrade Kwetu Mandashe, the National Chairperson of the African National Congress. We can say long live the spirit of Oliver Tambo as you end your own lecture. Thanks very much, National Chairperson, once again, for a good lecture, inspirational, talking to the crisis that we are faced with, talking to the leadership challenges, and secondly, giving us hope that we can still use Oliver Tambo exemplary leadership as an inspiration to take us out of the current crisis that we are in, both as a country, and secondly, inspire the organization to work collectively as it seeks to renew itself. Indeed, National Chairperson Oliver Tambo had utmost faith in the people of South Africa. Henceforth, his calls were not only to the leadership of the African National Congress, but to the masses of our country. There are messages that have been sent by various comrades as we are continuing with the lecture. Others were thanking you, Comrade Gwede, for the lecture and so on. But there was one that inspired me when you started. It was from Comrade Phoebe, who says, the National Chairperson is correct. We have never seen Comrade Oliver Tambo, but as students and youth of the 1980s, we loved and revered him and treasured his words. Not only the student leadership and the youth movement, but the entire populace of our country revered and treasured Oliver Tambo. Henceforth, they were able to follow the African National Congress wherever it seeks to direct the revolution towards. Thanks very much once again, Comrade Gwede. Can we therefore, as we close the lecture tonight,
invite Comrade Tshilidzi Munyai from the Gauteng province to thank us all and close the lecture of Oa Tambo tonight. As he does so, I want just to acknowledge that as many comrades have entered this particular platform, many provinces of the African National Congress did participate tonight in this particular lecture. From all provinces, Free State Secretary was here, comrades from Northwest were here, comrades from Mpumalanga, Limpopo, and some from KZN were also here. I want just to acknowledge them as we close the meeting. And thanks to the co-host, co-director, Comrade Mantu, for the ability to co-host the event. Can we therefore invite Comrade Munyai to close the meeting and close the event for all of ourselves? Comrade Munyai, are you there? Can we? I see you.
Thank you very much, Comrade Program Director. On behalf of the Gauteng province, allow me to really appreciate the input of National Chairperson Comrade Gwede Mantashe, and also all the speakers that spoke before our National Chairperson, Ekurhuleni, the ANC and the city, for really building a structure of historical of memory of historical significance that will continue to see from generation to generation and commemorate the alliance partners, the Youth League, and also all the structures of the African National Congress and the alliance that spoke, and also the importantly the audience that really sacrificed their time to listen to all our speakers and the discipline they've displayed. Comrade Chair, allow me in concluding remarks to really quote Oa Tambo during his January statement of 1995, the year of the CADA. Comrade President General said the following, Comrade Program Director, open quote, "The strength of any organization lies in the caliber of individual memberships or units. In order to advance in keeping with the momentum of our struggle, we must improve the quality and expand the quantity of our membership. We need cadres of unquestionable loyalty, dedication, and understanding of our struggle. In order to achieve such high standards and spare our nation into a greater onslaught of the enemy and its institution, we declare this year, 1985, a year of the CADA. So therefore, you could understand, comrades, that cadership development is a fundamental necessity for revolution. I think our national chair touched this point. But comrades, the old Marxists also said the following, open quote, "We cannot only understand our efforts at liberation if we don't understand the enemy's efforts at domination or oppression." Drawing from our President General Oa Tambo approach to complex situation in difficult situation, such as amongst others, the Morogoro Conference that the National Chairperson spoke about, we need concrete analysis of the current challenges facing our movement. Our understanding of national liberation is determined by our grasp of its antithesis. Comrades, the mechanism of a national operation need to be understood. Failure to understand how and where, why we were oppressed could lead to a strategic or tactical error as a liberation movement. It is only when we accurately, comrades, characterize the nature of the challenges that we face today that we can adopt appropriate tactics to advance our overall strategic objectives. that of non-racial, non-sexist, democratic, or prosperous, or more equal society, which we call today a national democratic society. On behalf of the Provincial Executive Committee Comrade Program Director, I really indeed honored to really thank you, all of you, and for the work that has been done since the beginning of this honor of this great giant, O.R. Tambo. On behalf of the PEC, allow me, comrades, to conclude this session with great honor and respect to everybody that participated. Thank you very much, and the session stand adjourned.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Long live the chair! Long live the chair!
Well done.